अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवत्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं येतावश्च प्रणोति तस्मै ब्रह्मदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचित्रगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यते नमः। पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहनमत्यं निश्चितां बुद्धिः। After the fourth taranga adhyaya of Vichara Sagara, where Chatvadrishti, the Uttama Adhikari, was addressed, and at the end of the patha, after Chatvadrishti understood the tattva by some basic fundamental teaching of Mahavakya and resolution of doubts that followed. The end of the chapter, there was a mention after the teaching. At the end of the chapter, there was a mention of who is an Uttama Adhikari. We closed with that yesterday. And Madhyama or Adhama Adhikari is one who needs more than the Mahavakya, who has more doubts about Srishti Prakriya or anything else. Tarka is needed. All of this will make a person an Adhama Adhikari, because Chitta Shuddhi is lacking, because Dharmika Karma is lesser. There is not enough effort put in before one came to Vedanta. So that effort has to continue, as well as the doubts have to be resolved. And these doubts are not only related to Mahavakya, they are related to the Pramana as well as Prameya. They can be related to those, they can be related to the Jagat also, they can be related to philosophical aspect as to why only Advaita Tattva. All these possibilities are there. Shraddha is also lesser. Thereby, the teaching continues with the other brothers. Here, Atha, thereafter, after the Uttama Adhikari teaching is over, Madhyama Adhikarinaha Upadesha Nirupanam Nama Panchamas Tarangaha. So, fifth chapter called as Madhyama Adhikarinaha Upadesha Nirupanam. The elaboration of teaching for the Madhyama Adhikari, who has sufficient Chitta Shuddhi to continue with Vedanta, but Mahavakya is not sufficient. Doubts are not only related to Mahavakya, but they are related to more than those. So 26 to 51st avarta deals with Guru Veda Prabhuti Naam Vyavaharika Satta Pratipadanam. What is the Satta of the Guru, Vedas, and everything that you put on a pedestal? You talk about Shraddha, Veda Shraddha, Vedanta Shraddha, Guru Shraddha, Shastra Shraddha is discussed. Now, what is their Satta? It is Vyavaharika Satta. So that is described here. Vedena Gurunacha Advaita Jnanodaya Sambhavaha Iti Adrushtehe Prashnaha. The second brother is called as Adrushti. Earlier one was Tattva Drushti. So Adrushti has a question. Adrushti, he missed out. He missed out what Tattva Drushti got. That Tattva he missed out. Therefore, he is called as Adrushti. And these names are given based on, it has a meaningful, the name is meaningful. The third one, brother, is called as Tarka Drushti. So Tarka Drushti needs Tarka for everything. Anything you say, whoever says it, he'll ask why. And we have come across such people. We have ourselves been such people at some point of time. Sometimes these questions come, why? Some don't get the question. They have Shraddha, enough Shraddha. For each why, they have a why not. Why not? Because if you give an answer, this is how it is, then they'll have the flip side also. Why only this way? So, Tarka never ends. It has to culminate somewhere. It has to conclude somewhere. And that should be in the Shruti. So, Shruti Moolaka Tarka is encouraged. Tarka, which is twisting the teaching both ways, that is not encouraged. That is discouraged. So, here, Vedena Gurunacha Advaita Jnanodayas Asambhavaha. There is no possibility itself. He starts with Asambhava. Iti Adrushtehe Prashnaha. What is not possible? The rise of knowledge. Jnanodaya is Asambhava. What kind of Jnana? Advaita Jnana. So the question is twofold. Veda and Guru being Vyavaharika, therefore, the jnana is not possible, or Advaita jnana itself is not possible, whoever teaches. Third aspect is Advaita jnana, as taught by Veda and Guru, who are in the Dvaita Prapancha, it is not possible. So, it's a very loaded question, and that needs elaboration. Shri Sadguru Mukhad Upadishta Vedanta Vakya Pramana Advaita Brahmatma Sakshatkaro Jayataiti Purvatarange Uktam. In the chapter that was closed, it was said that the Atma Sakshatkara, Brahmatma Sakshatkara is born. There is no Bheda between Brahma and Atma. So it is Advaita Brahmatma Sakshatkara. Jayate Iti Purva Tarange Uktam. This Advaita Brahmatma Sakshatkara, how is it born? Due to what reason? Kasmad Hetoho. Vedanta Vakya Pramanat. Due to the Upanishadic teaching, Mahavakya. And how does it work? When taught. So, Shri Sadguru Mukhad Upadishta. That Vedanta Vakya should be taught by a guru. And then only it will lead to Brahmatma Sakshatkara, Advaita Brahmatma Sakshatkara. Chachrutva Adrushti Namaka Dvitiya Shishyaha. The second Shishya, who is the second brother of the three, having heard that this Adrushti brother is Shishya as well, evam Shankate, he has a doubt. What does he say? Kim Guru Vedantascha Satya Uta Asatyaha. The Guru and Vedanta, are they Satya or Asatya? He is not even asking Mithya. He is asking Asat. Are they Satya or Asatya? So, it can have both meanings. If he has understood what was taught earlier as to Mithya, being Asat, there is still a pratiti. That is mithya. If he has not understood, then he uses the word asatya as shashashringa. So what is he really asking? Whatever it is, whether mithya or asat, he wants to know whether satya or not satya. We can just take asat, none just different from satya. Adya pakshe, meaning satya. If the guru and Vedanta are satya, then advaita hanihi. Advaita is not possible. You cannot have two sat and still satyas and sadeva satyam. Sat and satya are interchangeable. You cannot have guru and Vedanta as satya and Brahma as satya, Brahmatma as satya, and still say that there is advaita. So advaita is compromise, advaita hanihi. And what does it mean by advaita hani? Dvaita siddhischa. Dvaita is established as soon as you agree. And this is the Purva Paksha of Dvaitins also. They ask, you have Guru, you have Shishya, Guru Shishya Veda. You have Shruti also, Veda as Pramana. You have all sorts of divisions and you claim yourselves to be Advaitins. What kind of Advaita is it? Where everything is true. Because you are working with the Guru. You are working with the Karaka as Veda Vedanta. You believe in Karma Kanda also, you follow all that. And then you claim yourselves to be Advaitins. This is the Dvaita Akshepa. Dvaita Paksha Akshepa. So what does Bhagavad Padacharya say in Dakshinamurti Stotra? Vishwam Pashyati Karya Karanataya. Vishwam Pashyati Karya Karanataya. Saswami Sambhandataha. Shishyacharya Tatha Pitruputra Dhyatmanah Bhedataha. Swapne Jagrati Vayesha Purusho Maya Parigbhramitaha. Tasmai Shri Guru Murtaye Namaidam Shri Dakshinamurtaye. Vishwam Pashyati, Karya Karanataya Pashyati. So Pratiti is there. Karya Karanam Bheda, Pratiti is there. This is what Advaitin say. We say Pratiti is there. It is not Satya. Swaswami Sambandataha. Oneself and the master. So there is also a servant and a master Bheda. Be it for a bhakta, be it for a laukika, one who has been serving for family for years, he is like part of the family. The entire family of the those who serve, they are also part of the family there, but there is still bheda. Shishya and acharya bheda is there. Guru shishya bheda is there. So guru is different. Shishya is different. There is bheda. But pratiti is there. Pashyati. Drigdrishya Viveka tells us that drishyatvat mithya. Guru is mithya drishyatvat. Oh, then shishya is the truth. No, shishya is also mithya. Why? Shishya is sharira. Therefore, drishyatvat mithya. Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya explains this in Drigdrishya Viveka. Dvaitin say, just give me a moment, please. Sorry, I'm under the weather. So Dvaitin say that all that you have is Bheda. He is taking the Drishya Bheda as real. So they say Drishyatvat Satyam. We say Drishyatvat Mithya. Sadasadbhyam Anirvachaniya Mithya. Drishyatvat. Same Hetu. For them, it leads to Satya. For us, it leads to Mithya. Why? Maya Paribhramitaha. Mayaya Paribhramitaha. Due to being under the influence of Maya, which happens to be Vikshepa, which is due to Avarna. So, Adya Pakshe Advaita Hani Dvaita Siddhischa is not possible really. But that is a doubt. Dvitiye uta asatya. If Guru Vedanta are asatya, then dvitiye pakshe mithyabhuta marichikodakena pipasa pipasana apagamavad. असत्य भूत गुरु वेदांत ही संसार दुख अनिवृत्ति ही पुरुषार्थ असिद्धिश्च. सो इफ यू से नो देर इज नो सत्यत्वम टू गुरु एंड वेदांत देन असत्यत्वम इन दैट केस व्हाट विल हैपन लाइक द मिराज वाटर कैनॉट क्वेंच द थर्स्ट. Similarly, asadbhuta guru vedantahi samsara dukkha anivritti. So, asat you take as mithya. He says, I meant mithya. I understood what you taught. If they are mithya, then mithya water in the desert does not quench your thirst. Then how will this mithya guru and mithya Upanishad solve your problems? Samsara dukkha anivritti. Nivritti will not take place. Dukkha will continue to be there. It will not quench your thirst of dukkha nivritti. And purushartha asiddhischa moksha will not be possible. Evam pakshadvai api advaita jnanodaya sambhavaha. Jnanodaya sambhavaha. So pakshadve, it's a ubhayapasha rajju. You pick any end of a rope, he gives you a rope. You pick up any end of the rose, there is a noose. This would be in taraka, but this is a shishya asking. So he is genuinely interested. He says, I have heard this ubhayapasha nyaya, ubhayapasha rajju nyaya, I have heard from others. So they ask these questions, I don't know how to resolve this. So from a Shishya's perspective, it is not Ubhaya Pasharaju. He is just presenting the Ubhaya Pasharaju to the Guru. He says, I don't know how to answer this because I owned up their doubts. They have the doubts. Even if I didn't inquire much, now they are my doubts. And I don't know how to resolve this. Therefore, I want to know. Not for their sake, for my sake. Evam pakshadvayapi advaita jnanodaya asambhavaha. Advaita jnana cannot take place because earlier case advaita hani. How can there be advaita jnana? Dvaita is established by that. In the second case, advaita which leads to moksha, that is not possible. Samsara dukkha nivritti will not take place. Therefore also advaita jnanodaya asambhava. So, evam pakshadvayapi advaita jnanodaya asambhava eva iti Shankaracharya Shankaracharya sthapitam advaita matam apramanikam eva iti mama shankam krupaya apanetum arhasi iti shishyav prichyati. So, adrishti asks that in both cases, there is advaita jnanodaya asambhava. Advaita jnana cannot take place. Therefore, the advaita jnana as established, which was there earlier, but it was established systematically by Shankaracharya. Adya Shankaracharya. So, Shankaracharya sthapitam advaita matam. It is apramanikam because it cannot be in either of the case, if the Guru Vedanta are real or mithya, in both cases, Advaita cannot be established. Advaita Jnanodaya is not possible. Therefore, Advaita Mata itself is apramanika. Because if it is pramanika, then being pramana, it should lead to Jnanodaya, Advaita Jnanodaya, Advaita Pramanika Mata, had it been Pramanika, then Advaita Mata should lead to Jnanodaya, Advaita Jnanodaya. Since it does not lead to Advaita Jnanodaya in both cases, therefore Advaita Mata is Apramanika. This is my doubt, he says. Mama Shankam Krupaya Apanetum Arhasi. And you ought to take away this doubt. Who else? you have to take away this doubt of mine. So the answer is given. Shri Sadguru Uttaram Shankaramatasya Advaitasya Pramanikatva Varnanam. He says it is definitely Pramanika. Shankara Mata, Advaita Mata has validity. It will lead to Jnanodaya. That is the Sankshepa there. Shankara Matasya Pramanikatve Vyasa Vachanam. First he gives, he says, I will teach, but then there have to be some great personalities that have gone by. Everyone knows them. Great works are there. So they have to be brought in to establish facts. Even in a, you know, in a court argument, they'll bring in other orders and give references so that there is weightage to your argument. And they are all well respected. They'll bring a Supreme Court order to the High Court. What is High Court going to do? So you have to follow. Now in this question, when he says Dvaita Siddhichya, if you take the Dvaita Paksha, they don't have an issue with Guru and Vedanta being Satya. They don't say they are Asatya. They say Guru and Vedanta are Satya. Then they'll say that what you have derived from the Vedanta, what your Guru has derived from the Vedanta, Adi Guru, not Adi Guru, but then Sampradaya Guru, Sampradaya with, not Sampradaya Krit, that kind of a Bhagavan Bhashyakara that you talk about, his interpretation is not right. Advaita. Why? Vedanta is real. And Vedanta, Upanishad being Satya, there is already Dvaita Siddhi. Because Brahma is Satya. At least two Satyas are there. There is one Brahma which is Satya and Upanishad which is Satya. Guru is also Satya, but let's set that aside for the time being. Then, in your sampradaya, the interpretation of Vedanta as culminating in Advaita cannot be right because it is contradictory. Now that you accepted that Satya, Vedanta is Satya. In which case, you are hunting for Advaita in Upanishad is wrong. So even if it appears to be Advaita, that is not the Tatparya. That's some kind of a glorification. Arthavada. Or words have to be supplied. You have to do a right anvaya. You have to follow some other rules which are unknown. Or we have to break the Vyakrana rules and apply something whereby we'll get only Dvaita Siddhi even from the Advaita Vakyas. Tattvamasi should not be Tattvamasi. By ing of Padanta Dati, we should separate it out as Shweta Keto Tattvamasi. Okara is there. Ing of Padanta Dati will give you a split as Atattvamasi. So Shweta Keto is not a separate word per se. It is a separate word by Sambodhana, but then it is not separated from Tat. It is separated from Atat. So your Padacheda is wrong. Shweta Keto Tattvamasi, it is not what is said. Shweta Keto Atattvamasi. You are not Tat. Or, if you say it as Tattvamasi, then they will say Tasyattvamasi, Tenattvamasi, Tasmattvamasi, Tasmintvamasi. All these Tatpurusha Samasas are possible. It is not the right Padacheda there also. If you make the Padacheda as Tat as a separate Pada, it should be Atat by ing of Padanta. Atat, Tvam, Asi. If you make the Padacheda as Tat itself, then Tat cannot dangle on separately. It should be in a Samasa as Tattvam. Tattvam, Asi. and that tattvam can be split by various karakarthas, tenatvam, tasmatvam, tasmintvam, ityadi, all sorts of explanations should be given for dvaita siddhi, because advaita is erroneous. This would be the argument. And due to that argument being possible, as in your acharyas, who are they? This is how they talk. In fact, they are more insulting. I am toning down. The Purvapaksha, which has come up after Bhagavad Pada Acharya, they are all derogatory. Not all, but many of them are derogatory. They call names. There is name calling because their philosophy itself does not stand ground. They add words. Atattvamasi is grammatically possible. There are some other places where they have added some unknown kind of Vyakrana interpretation. They add words as well. Because for them, their pre-concluded Dvaita notions are carrying more weightage than Shruti itself. There is no Tatpare Nishchaya Parche. There is no Shadlinga analysis done properly. For them, Pramana is Padma Purana, Bhagavat Purana. Even Bhagavat Purana, they take very specifics. Bhagavat Purana also will be quoted here as having Advaita as Tatparya. They have a very weird hierarchy of Pramanas. For us, Shruti is Mula Pramana. Anything else that even appears to contradict Shruti has to be reinterpreted. We don't reinterpret Shruti. Between Shruti and Shruti, if there is an apparent contradiction, then we take Tatparya Linga and interpret the Shruti without supplying additional words. We use Lakshana. Lakshana is a very logical way to do it when the direct meaning does not make sense. Primary meaning. Direct meaning is primary meaning. When the Mukhyartha does not make sense, Vachyartha does not make sense as it is. Does not make sense in the sense it is either not making any sense or it is completely out of place in the context or it is contradictory to, we can say and or contradictory to the Tatparya Nishchaya brought out by Shadlinga analysis. Then we have to reinterpret that Shruti statement also. This is what Advaitins do. Dvaitins take Padma Purana and others as primary. Tarkikas take logic as primary. Tarka as primary, then they reinterpret the Shruti also. Or they'll say Shruti also says it. They'll be very picky. Advaita is the only sampradaya which can explain all vakyas, karma kanda, jnana kanda, upasana kanda included. Because we have bheda in drishti. We have vyavharika drishti, we have paramarthika drishti. So they all have purposes. Finally, they'll be all tuned towards purushartha siddhi, but kramena. So they have at a particular stage of life and particular stage of the jiva also, based on his own accumulated karma and the state of the chitta, each of the sections of Vedas is valid for that particular jiva, set of jivas. Anyway, in that background, because the Aropa is that if it is Advaita Hani and Dvaita Siddhi, then it amounts to mean that your Acharyas have misinterpreted Upanishads. In which case, we have to bring in those that they respect and show them that how it is when you say that our Acharyas have, Sampradaya Acharyas have misinterpreted Shruti, then the Acharyas that you respect, who are we consider them to be belonging to our sampradaya. You are the ones who have split from Advaita and made your own sampradaya. So you have wavered away from the path. Those who have come after Bhagavad Padacharya have actually left the sampradaya. That's why they are asampradaya with. They can say claim that our sampradaya started from Narayana as well. But can it be established? Because who was the Acharya of your Sampradaya Kartas? Not Narayana, tracing back to Narayana. If you look at the chain, there is some Advaita Acharya. Who did not teach you Dvaita? So you left your Sampradaya. So you cannot be Sampradaya with, by the very reasoning that your Acharya did not teach you Advaita. I mean, did not teach you Dvaita. He taught you Advaita because it was an Advaita Acharya. And you disagreed with him and you started your own Sampradaya. How can you trace back to Narayana? There is at least a break at that level in Sampradaya. So it is not Sampradaya tracing to Narayana. It cannot be. They claim. But this is how we have to understand as to what is a Sampradaya, what is not a Sampradaya. If one cannot trace to one's own Guru, then it is Sakapola Kalpita. It is all imagined, and this will be shown now by quoting the Diggaj Vyaktis who are respected in all Sampradayas. So Vyasacharya is brought in and said that, did Vyasacharya talk about Advaita? Are you going to reinterpret his words? How will you reinterpret these words? They are simpler than Shruti. It is not difficult to interpret. They are in simple shlokas. So Shankaramatasya Pramanikatve Vyasavachanam. Shankaramatasya Advaita Matasya Pramanikatve Maharshi Vyasavachanam. That kind of a Vyasa has talked about this. Bhagavan Vyasacharya has talked about Pramanikatvam of not Advaita Mata only. He has talked about Shankaramata looking ahead. That is what in Puranas, the Kavis are Krantadrishtis. Krantadrishtis means they see more than us. They see beyond the time limitations that we have. They know the future and the past in which they may not have existed. They are Siddhas. So Kavis are not only Kavis, these Kavis. There are other Kavis who are, you know, Kavis who do Hasya Kavi Sammelan also. But that is not Krantadrishti. But here, Bhagavan Vyasa, who is a Kavi, is Krantadrishti. Shri Vyasena Vayaviya Kurmadi Puraneshu. So there are 18 Puranas in which there is a Kurmadi Purana also. Shankaramatam Adhikritya Evam Uchyate. So by Bhagavan Vyasa, what has been said? He has taken Shankaramata as basis. Therefore, he says, Kalau yuge tu vedartho varnyate hyanyatha yanyata hyanyatha nyatha Shankaracharya rupena shiva sakshat tadakila. Sorry, I'll repeat it. There were errors. Kalau yuge tu vedartho varnyate hyanyatha nyatha Shankaracharya rupena shiva sakshat tadakila. So since I've been saying Shankaramata, when it is Shankaracharya, there also the tongue is set for Shankara. So Kalau Yuge, in Kali Yuga, Vedartha, Vedantartha, entire Vedartha culminating in Vedanta, and that Vedanta also, which can be confusing, has been described. Varnyate, Anyatha, Anyatha. He, indeed, it has been described in Kali Yuga differently. So before Kali Yuga, there wasn't misinterpretation of Vedartha. It was described not in many ways. So maybe in some ways or maybe only in one way, which is Advaita. Therefore, Shankaracharya Rupena Shivaha Sakshat Tadakila. Anvaya is not complete. Shankaracharya Rupena Shivaha Sakshat Tadakila what? Because of this reason. The earlier Artha is a Hetu for the Uttarartha. So, Purvartha is a Hetu for Uttarartha. Therefore, what? Tada. Tada kada? Kalav Yuge. Yada Vedartha Anyatha Anyatha Varnyate. Kaishchit. By anyone. All of these people. By them, Vedartha has been described in many ways. Therefore, Tada, what will happen? That becomes a Tada Kila. शिवः साक्षात् शंकराचार्य रूपेण अवतीर्य. सो भगवान शिवा हिमसेल्फ टुक दी अवतार ऑफ शंकराचार्य. सो अवतीर्यान् यथाभूतम् जैन बौद्धादिकम् मतम् निर्मूलयिष्यत्यखिलम् वेदवाक्यै सयुक्तिः. एंड नॉट ओनली वेदार्थः बट अवेदार्थ ऑल्सो अगेंस्ट दी वेदास. जैनास बौद्धास दे हैव ऑल्सो स्टडीड वेदास एंड एस्टैब्लिश देयर ओन फॉर वॉट एवर रीजन वेदर दे कुड नॉट सी दी कर्मकांड हिंसा. दिस ऑल रीजनिंग इज गिवन. इवन इफ यू एग्री दैट जैन एंड बुद्ध by you know by benefit of doubt you agree that they were muktas in the sense of advaita sampradaya also, then it is not without vedas. They have may have gone against the vedas, but then they may have got mukti due to advaita study in the vedas. They may have established philosophical thought differently, or their followers have misinterpreted their own teachings. All these possibilities exist. Even if we give benefit of doubt, it is possible only because of mukti is possible only because of Vedartha being studied properly. In any case, Jaina and Bauddhas are those who follow their mata, their philosophy, which is not Vedartha. So Avedartha, Vedartha as well as Avedartha is there. So there are others who have interpreted Vedanta differently, Veda differently. Therefore, the Shad Darshanas, which are Astika Darshanas, then Nastika Darshanas, Jaina Bauddha, Charvaka, Avatiryan, Yathab, Avatiryan. So Shankaracharya Rupena Avatiryan, Yathabhutam, Jaina Bauddhadikam Matam, Nirmulaishyati. Shows that there is no moola, causative. He will. It is ritlakara and causative also. So when Bhagavan Vyasa created this Puranas, he said that this is going to happen in Kali Yuga. Bhagavan Shiva will take, Ishvara himself will take Shankaracharya Rupa and then Nirmula Ishyati, Akhilam. Veda Vakya, all this. Akhilam what? Akhilam Matam. What kind of Matam? Jaina Bauddhadikam. Not only Panyatha Anyatha interpreted, but also Jaina Bauddhadikam Matam, which is Avaidika. Akhilam, completely Nirmulayishyati. That is why he took the Sarvajna Pitha in Kashmira. Sarvajna Pitha, because he dismantled all these systematically made Avaidika as well as systematically made Vaidika systems, philosophies, darshanas, by showing that they have no moola, nirmulayishyati, dismantled completely, showing that empty, like, you know, you take away the layers and layers of onion and within there is nothing. So you dismantle one at a time. How? Sayukti bihi. Along with yuktis. Vedavakyehi sayukti bihi vedavakyehi. Yukti bihi saha vartante iti. Sayuktini vedavakyani. That's Vedavakyas are neuter. So yukti bihi saha vartante iti sayuktini vedavakyani taihi sayukti bihi vedavakyaihi akhilam jaina bauddhadikam matam nirmulishyati. Kaha saha? Shivaha sakshat Shankaracharya rupena avatiryan. Having taken avatara in the form of Shankaracharya, Yathabhutam Varnyate, we can say that, Yathabhutam Varnyate, Vedartha, and Jaina, or we can say Yathabhutam Jaina Bauddhadikam Matam, as it existed then. Nirmulishyati. Nirmulayishyati. He will dismantle by showing that they have no basis. Udhritya Murti Gangaya Stapayishyati Vai Prabhoho Suryalokena Jagato Yandakara Vinashane Yathavasthita Bhanantu Padarthana Yathabhavet Nashaschavi Paritakhya Bhavanaya Yathabhavet Sarvasamshe Nashaschya Bhagavat Pujyapada Vrit Shankaropita Thaiveha Lokanugrahakangshaya. Since the Anvaya goes across, I thought I'll read all this. Udhritya Murti Gangaya. So it can be Udhritya Murtim Gangaya. Murti Lingam. So I think it should be Murtim. Udhritya Murtim Gangaya. Stapayishyati Vai Prabhoho. Surya Lokena Jagato Yandakara Vinashane. So Surya Aloka, just like the Prakasha, Surya Prakasha, Jagata Andhakara Vinashane. It takes away the darkness, Andhakara of the Jagat. Similarly with the Lingas, this Murti, Gangayaha, here, Udhritya Murti Gangayaha, Stapayishyati Vai Prabhoho. Anyway, not much there. I mean, I don't want to inquire into this, what all this means. But Stapayishyati, he will establish a mata which will take away the tamaha, ajnana, rupa andhakara of the jagat, just like the Surya takes away the literal andhakara. Yatha avasthita bhanantu padarthanam yatha bhavet, nashascha viparitakhya bhavanaya yatha bhavet. Sarva samshe nashascha bhagavat puja pada bhrut. So he himself has given the name bhagavat puja pada. Sarva samshe nashascha shankara api tathayeva iha lokanugrah kangshaya. So Anvaya is across, but we'll look at the Bhavartha. Bhavartha, he will finally lead to Sarva Samshaya Nashascha. I'll keep it simple instead of going into each and every pada, because I'll also have to look at across and sit and make an Anvaya. We get the idea. It's this, slokas are simple. Shankara api tathayeva lokanugrah kangsha. What is the akanksha with which he took the avatar also? That is mentioned here. Viparita bhavana. All to take away all that. Yathavasita bhana, to create that. Padarthana, whatever is there. Yathabhavet. So yathabhavet tatha, in fact, you look at it in that sense. Vedartha Vishyajnanam Bhranti Samshaya Karanam Nishesham Nashetva Aso Sadhaitva Dvayam Param Advaya Brahma Vidyancha Stapayed Avanitale Anyathavaranayed Yastu Vedhartam Sa Tunamudadhihi Iti. So Vedartha Vishyajnana Bhranti Samshaya Karanam, which is the Karana for Bhranti and Samshaya. Nishesham, without leaving anything, Nashaitva, having destroyed, Asau, Shankaraha, Sadhaitva, Advayam, Param Sadhaitva, Lyabanta again, having established Advaita as the highest Mata, Advaya Brahma Vidyancha Sthapayed, he will establish, systematically establish the Advaya Brahma Vidya, where Avanitale, on Prithvi, Anyatha Varnayed Yastu. Whoever describes something different from this. Anyatha. Anyatha Kasmad Anyatha. Or Kasyaha Anyatha. Advaya Brahma Vidyayaha Anyatha Yaha Tu Varnayed. What Varnayed? Vedartham. Who explains Vedartha, the Tatpare of Veda Vedanta, as different from Advaya Brahma Vidya. Satu Mudadhi. So every darshana has been included in that. Not one or two. Is it Advaya Brahma Vidya? No. So we'll call whom as Dvaitins. What is Dvaita for us? Advaita is what na dvaitam iti advaitam. Or dvaitam na vidyate yasmin iti advaitam. Matam. So if we derive in this manner, let's say advaita matam is equal to dvaitam na vidyate yasmin mate tad matam advaita matam. And then we re-derive dvaita. How? Na advaitam iti dvaitam. Na advaitam iti dvaitam. So we negate advaita and make a tatpurusha out of it. Earlier, let's say it as a bahuri for simplicity, you know, to explain, make a difference. Where there is no duality, no possibility of duality, and therefore impossibility of plurality also. That kind of mata, dvaitam na vidyate yasmin mate, tad shankara matam advaita matam. And anything different from that, it can be shunyavada, charvakavada, dvaitavada, visheshtadvaitavada, dvaitadvaitavada, shuddhadvaitavada, ekadeshivada, scientific, western philosophy, other religious thought, everything is included. Is it advaita? It is not advaita. Dvaitam na vidyate yasmin iti advaitam, na advaitam iti dvaitam. That kind of mata which is not advaita. Meaning, advaya brahma vidyayaha anyatha. Yaha vedartham varnayed. Vedartham avedartham api. Yaha varnayed. Sahatu mudadhihi. There cannot be clearer words. We don't have to insult. We don't have to name call anyone. They name call us, but we don't have to call, because Bhagavan Vyasa Maharshi has already done this. He said they are mudadhi means what? It is also bahuri. Mudadhihi yasya. Saha mudadhihi. One who is not, definitely not an uttamadhikari. Not even a madhyamadhikari, because madhyamadhikari will also, you will see here, adrishti will also in the end get the tattva. Not even adhamadhikari, because charkadrishti will also finally get advaita tattva. Moodadhihi, who insists on holding on to his moodatha. He holds on to the delusion as satya and does name calling. Thereby moodadhihi iti mahita mahetiyase mahaitiyase mahetiyase shivarasye navamshe cha shankaravatasya upanishadatvam uchyate. It has been stated even in shivarasya, which is mahaitiyasa. In navamsha it has been mentioned, Shive madamsha sambhuta shankara shankarottamaha chaturvissa shishyaischa kalavatarichyati tasmai chopanishadvidya maya datta maheshwari bhumau pashanda shandanam khandanam sakarishyati ityadina. And it has been mentioned as what? Shive madamsha sambhuta shankara shankarottamaha. Shankara by name Uttamaha. Shankaroti iti Shankaraha. Who brings about auspiciousness to everyone. Karoti karishyati api. Karishyati. So he makes it possible for you as well. Brings about auspiciousness. Therefore Uttamaha. Shankaranam api uttamaha. Ye shankurvanti tesham api uttama iti shankarottamaha. that kind of auspiciousness he would bring compared to all those who bring about auspiciousness, Shubha, Sham, Ananda, he is Uttama. That kind of Shankara, Madamsha Sambhutaha. He is born out of Maya Amsha, says Shiva, Bhagavan Shiva, Chaturvisa Shishyaischa, and he will be along with his four Shishyas establishing four Mathas. Kalau Avatarishyati, he will take Avatara in Kali Yuga. Tasmaicha Upanishad Vidya Maya Datta Maheshwari, where did he get it? He got it from Shiva himself. How so? By being an Amsha one. Or before creating the Bhashya, Bhagavan Shankaracharya studied, it is said, I think 7 or 8 times he studied Shiva Samhita. So Shiva Samhita, he studied 8 times or 7 times. I forget the number, forgive me for that. Before he went ahead and created the Bhashya, on which there is a Bhashya on Shiva Samhita also, by Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya. So thereby also Shiva has given the Upanishad Vidya to Bhagavat Padacharya. Bhumau Pashanda Shandanam Khandanam Sa Karishyati. So he is going to do Khandanam. Who are, you know, Pashanda, they are, you know, deceiving. They don't tell you really Vedartha. Either they know and they don't tell you, or they deceive. Whatever it is, you know, Pashanda Shandanam. Itihasa Purananancha Vedartha Upabrahmana Eva Upayoga Iti Abhyukta Vachanam Api. And in Itihasa Purana also, the culmination of thought in Veda, the growth is mentioned, the Upabrahmana Eva Upayoga Ha. Iti Abhyukta Vachanam Api. Bibhetyalpa Shrutadvedo Mamayam Pratarishyati Itihasa Purana Abhyam Vedam Samupabruhayet Iti. So all that has elaboration which is done in the Bhashya. So Vedaha Alpa Shrutad Bibheti. Those who have not studied the Vedas completely, how will they have Vedartha? If you start setting aside Vakyas that are not in line with your thought, in line with your philosophy, you are Alpa Shruta. You are not Bahushruta. There is no Upabrahmana. There is no growth in your philosophy. There is no expanse in your philosophy, because there is no expanse in the study. The study is very little. Whatever extra study comes in, you are unable to resolve, you set it aside. As a Purva Mimamsaka, you would set it aside as saying Arthavada. As a Dvaiti, other kinds of Vedantins, so-called Vedantins, I say so-called Vedantins, because who is qualified, really qualified to be called as Vedantin? For whom Vedanta is the Pramana. If you are going to bring in Padma Purana to interpret Upanishad, Vedanta, then how is Vedanta Pramana for you? It is not the Pramana, it is not even the Mukhya Pramana, because you are interpreting Vedanta with Padma Purana. Then, do you really qualify to be called as Vedantin? In my opinion, in my humble opinion, not so. Thereby, Alpa Shrutad Vedaha Api Vibheti. So even Veda, Shruti Mata, worries. She fears the people who study little of what she has to say. Everything else you set aside. Oh, I just like this part. Everything else, Arthavada. Or you add words. Itihasa Purana Abhyam Vedam Samupabruhayet. So anyway, the main idea there is, the Shruti should be taken its in entirety, not in bits and pieces. You should be able to explain, understand and explain each and every component of the Shruti. What is the purpose of each part, each section? You can't say this section is not useful. Advaita takes all that into account and does Tatparya Linga analysis by Shadlinga. Thereby, we are able to explain as to what purpose each section serves, at what level of satta is each section, what is it catering to. So that is the background given, sources given. These are the sources given by the guru to the Shishya, who is a Madhyama Adhikari and had doubts as to whether Advaita Siddhi is possible. Advaita Matamiva Pramanikam Iti Valmiki Valmikehe Api Abhipraya. Even Valmiki Maharshi, who wrote, who created, so saying wrote, who created Ramayana, and that teaching also has gone into, you know, in not only Valmiki, but then in Ramayana, you see Rama, who is an avatara, who was taught, whether or not he needed the teaching, he was the nimitta for the teaching, which has been retained, or most of it has been retained for our benefit. So in Ramayana also there is an Advaita thought. In Valmiki Ramayana also, and in Yoga Vasishta also. So Vasishta Muni was also Bhagavan Rama's Acharya. So in those teachings also, there is Advaita. This we'll see in the next part. Sukhan Nityam Swaprakasham Vyapakan Namur Adhishthanam Buddhya Bhutyam Buddhya Dukyatni Nirvana Param Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramha Tadevam Muttanya Dime Nishchitamatihi. See in the next part. Namaste. Any questions? Namaste.
Namaste.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.